Let me go across to our panelists who've patiently been with us for the past 40 minutes now and straight away open this up for conversation. And again, I will start with the representative from Maharashtra, because at the end of the day, the big fight about vaccination starts from Maharashtra, the state that claims they've run out of vaccines. Dr. Rahul, Prime Minister says vaccine is not the only tool. Why don't you contain the spread by higher testing and following COVID norms?
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, see, we can see the percentage of cases that are 50% of cases in India are in Maharashtra. And still, highest vaccinations are done in Maharashtra state only. The now second state of second wave, worst affected if state is there, so it is also Maharashtra. So the fight is still on. We are struggling in testing also, treatment also we are very much nicely giving. Vaccination also, we are highest in vaccination also. So we started with the most vulnerable group in vaccination. Health workers first, then police. Now more and more cases are found in younger age group. So that seems very serious, I think. And so we want to reach each and each, every person in our state. So we can, and we are facing scarcity of vaccine stock. So in that view, we need the help of central government, and center should support Maharashtra without being biased. Because see, we are most affected, and the center should see us first as a head of the family. We can see our India, our country is one family.
Yeah.
So center should provide us more vaccines, I think, because our target was 2 lakhs per day. But yesterday, due to scarcity of vaccine, we could vaccinated only 1.10 lakh of people. So if within 3 days we are not getting more vaccine stock, then we have to stop vaccination program. Already we have closed 26 out of 120 vaccination centers. So it is very serious if one has taken one dose of vaccine.
So centers, Dr. Shubha Rahul, centers, a few of the centers in Mumbai have shut, few of the centers in Pune have shut, centers in Sangli, in Panvel have also shut down. Is this also happening in other parts of the state already?
Yeah, but that not we are doing purposely, no? We are facing scarcity. That's why we seek the help from central government.
Okay.
What we can do now?
Okay. Yeah. Stay on with me, please. I'm going to bring in Kalikesh Dev as well. The other state that seems to have suggested that half your vaccination centers have no doses. Is that true, Kalikesh? You may be on mute.
Sorry.
Yeah.
I think you've spoken to the health ministry officials, and I think they've given you some data. I'm not clear on exact data that's available in the state, but yes, there's a huge shortage of vaccines, and there is a large and a growing interest in people wanting to take vaccines, except that we aren't just getting enough vaccines. Now, I understand the Prime Minister's message, which he gave in the last half an hour, 45 minutes, that there are other tools to address this issue. But that doesn't take away from the problem, from the issue that there is a shortage of vaccines.
Mm.
And why in the last 1 year, when we have 2 or 3 vaccine makers in our country making vaccines, why are we running short when we're exporting so much of vaccines outside the country? Number two, why haven't we approved some of the other vaccines which have been seeking approval in the country for the last 3 or 4 months? So there's no reason to limit it or create artificial shortages by, you know, mishandling the kind of rationing that's going on. This is not the 1970s license Raj. You've got to allow supply to come in. You've got to allow the people who really want to take the vaccines to be able to get them, and to ensure that market forces are work progressing to ensure that people get enough, the vaccine makers get enough remuneration for it. I think there we messed up completely. So yes, in short, to answer your question, we are facing shortage of vaccines. It's going to be a huge crisis because it's in the middle of a massive second wave, which is happening now. This is when we need to really accelerate our vaccine program and not sort of start curbing it down because of a lack of supply of vaccine. I don't think we should be playing politics. I believe there is some discrepancy in numbers based on population per capita vaccine supplier from the center. I don't think that's correct. I think we need to completely open up the game and allow other vaccine makers to come in so that if there is a shortage in supply of production, we can make it up with other vaccines.
Other vaccine makers whose vaccines have been globally seen, tested and approved, other existing vaccine makers in our country. We are the vaccine hub. We are the pharma hub for this world. And we are even refusing to look at the option of bringing in other manufacturers, ramping up our facility. We're just staring at the situation which says, oh, Serum Institute can produce 6 crore today. Maybe they'll be able to produce 10 crore by June. And so what? We got to wait. That's all we have to do. Tuhin, is that what we're looking at? I don't know why the center is saying there is no shortage when we have now examples from different states where centers have shut down because they don't have vaccines.
Tanvi, there is absolutely no shortage of vaccines in the country. And let me today take you through some basic maths to explain that. You know, till date, 90 million single doses have been administered. Now, assuming a modest production capacity, which is out in public domain, of 70 million per month, 420 million vaccine doses would be manufactured in India between Jan and June. Now, out of these, 80 million have been exported. And there has been a stoppage of export now. So that brings the number down to 340 million. Now, I am assuming 20 million would be wasted. The primary culprit over here is Maharashtra, which has already wasted 5 million doses. So that brings the number down to 320 million. Now, in the 80 days remaining from now to June 30th, even if we vaccinate 4 million people a day, which is a fairly achievable target, there will be no shortage of vaccines.
No, we've already reached that. What are you talking about? We've already reached 40 lakh a day. We've already reached 40 lakh a day. All the states are raring to go to do a lot more. The center said, Tuhin, we will do 50 lakh a day, 5 million a day. We don't have these vaccines as far as the production is concerned. I am quoting to you what the center owns. 1 minute, please. You're talking about math. Here is the math for you. Here is the math, Tuhin. 4.5 crore vaccines is what is there in the pipeline. Please listen to me.
No, I need to complete my point. Sputnik V is yet to be approved in the next 2 weeks. I was talking of the existing production capacity. That production capacity will increase to hopefully 5 to 6 million easily by first week of May. I'm assuming Sputnik V is held up because of some basic queries, which will be answered in the next 2 weeks. So that will take the number up to 5 to 6 million a day. Now, the Prime Minister has clearly emphasized that vaccination will, you know, at a time when a TPR of 25% is not being brought down by the Maharashtra government for the last 4 weeks, do you think that vaccination for all will really help at this stage? Because even if we were to open vaccination for all, it would take the next 3.5 months for you to vaccinate all.
So obviously, we can't do vaccinate for all because you don't even have vaccines for the people who are eligible right now. What are you talking about? You dirt. 4.5 crore by health minister's own admission on Twitter. There are 4.5 crore vaccine doses in the pipeline. If we are clocking 40 lakh a day, if we are clocking 40 lakh a day, Tuhin, we don't even have a stock for more than 15 days. That's the truth.
That will be sorted out.
That's a mathematical. That's math. That's simple math. Reena Gupta, please. Reena Gupta, what is the status in Delhi? I know in Ghaziabad and Noida, where our reporters went today, we found vaccine centers that are shut down. There were posters, notice at the entrance saying no vaccines available. What is the status in Delhi?
Tanvi, I think the central government has shown very clearly that they're totally incompetent at handling this whole COVID crisis. You know, they've been so distracted with the elections. For a small MLA election, the whole cabinet was campaigning in West Bengal. And that is the reason why the whole process has been so slow. We started vaccinating in January, then we opened it to, you know, frontline workers, healthcare workers. And I think the whole opening of vaccine to other categories of people has been so slow. Number two, you know, they are playing really cheap politics. What is their responsibility? Their responsibility is to approve vaccines and make sure they're available to the states. then it's up to the states to make sure that all our, you know, all our people are vaccinated. So what is this, this Mai Baap kind of an attitude that, you know, we won't give it to this state or we'll give it to that state. We should have a proper, transparent policy so that nobody tomorrow is able to say that you are playing cheap politics. Why don't we have a proper, transparent policy for vaccination? And, you know, if you can't do it, you give it to the states. You allow us. We will start importing vaccines and start vaccinating our people. There are at least 10 vaccines which are approved in the international, international market. So if you can't do that job, you know, allow us, we'll vaccinate our people. We'll start importing and we'll start vaccinating. Having said that, now, you know, it's very, very heartening to hear the Prime Minister say, let's do a vaccine utsav. How do we do a vaccine utsav? We've been wanting to take vaccine to every mohalla of Delhi. How do we do that if we don't have proper supply of vaccine and we are not allowed to vaccinate outside of hospitals? We have been saying, allow us to take vaccines to every area of Delhi. So unless you give us an assured supply of vaccine, we will not be able to do that. And it is not just that you are seeing vaccine shortage in opposition states. In Ghaziabad, as you rightly said, which is a BJP ruled state, just on the outskirts of Delhi, there's a huge vaccine shortage. As far as Delhi is concerned, we have supply for the next 3 or 4 days as of now. But we've been requesting the center and, you know, we've been requesting again and again, please allow us to vaccinate everybody above 18 and we will finish the vaccination process in the whole of Delhi in 3 months.
No, but Reena Gupta, here is the point where the Prime Minister says focus on the vulnerable, focus on the elderly. Do you have enough vaccines to do that? How much of your, what percentage of that population has Delhi managed to cover?
So, Tanvi, I don't have exact figures of what percentage of the vulnerable we've managed to cover, but we are vaccinating around 85,000 to 1 lakh people every day.
Yeah.
And our government, we have 33 centers now which are open 24/7. Government of Delhi centers which are open 24/7 because we realized that a lot of people were complaining that they cannot afford to take a day off. You know, okay. A lot of people depend on daily wage to earn their livelihoods.
Right.
So that's the reason why we took this decision to have, 33 centers which are open 24/7. As far as Delhi's...
Yeah, okay, got the point. Well, that's what anybody would do if you want to do a Tika Utsav. But the point is you need the Tikas for that to give it to the people. You need the doses to give it to the people. I know in Maharashtra they don't have. In several other states, that seem to be what the states are claiming. Anshu Lovjeet, but this whole allegation that it's being done to target the opposition-governed states, can we really say that when the top 2 out of 3 states are opposition-governed states in terms of vaccine allocation?
It's a very circular debate. You know, I'm going to say no, it's not. You're going to say no, they're targeting the states. There's a center versus state conflict. You know, we're stuck in a time warp if you go on in this circular fashion. Let me just tell you something. We're in a huge monumental mess. I mean, we're staring down an abyss. And, Mr. Tohin, my honorable counterparts of figures were all messed up. And I was actually astonished to hear the speech of the Prime Minister where he has passed on the onus actually to civil society of doing something about the COVID crisis. It's like not what we can do for you, but what the people can do for the government at this particular time. It's hugely ironical that a time when we'll be looking at vaccinations, we keep talking about testing and tracing as if it's still the first wave. He glossed over the fact about COVID management regarding the vaccination process. In fact, he talked about celebrities and their responsibilities, of opinion makers and their responsibilities, of the youth, and even the poor governor was dragged out of his Raj Bhavan, where he might have been sitting comfortably, to do a webinar as if that's going to bring our figures down. It's astonishing why the Prime Minister, when he compared our country to richest countries in the world, where he said, no, we are following their own protocol. We are doing what they did. So we can't be really held responsible for the mess that's going on. What the Prime Minister does forget, and what I think everyone does forget, is that our population is 130 crores. What kind of bandobast and intizam have you made for 130 crore people? How soon are they going to get vaccinated? What is the orders of vaccination from the Serum Institute? Why has it not been diversified? What is the stage Sputnik 5 is in? Have bridge trials been conducted? a number of questions which the Prime Minister should have addressed, and predominantly that of wastage, of which he does go on, but shortages on various states have been left completely unaddressed by the Prime Minister.
No, okay.
These shortages, so, mind you, Tanvi, are not just one point. These are not just coming from non-BJP states. They're in UP. I'll give you the example of Banaras as well, where half the centers have shut down because they are not complaining openly because they're BJP states.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean there are shortages not there. They're everywhere across the board, pan-Indian, and nobody's doing anything about it. The onus is on civil society.
So vaccination is one part, and I think that is a tool for sure. But I will disagree with you, Anshul, when you say testing and tracking was for phase one. It's not. Testing is tracking, and tracking is here until COVID is here. Even after you get 50% of your population vaccinated, we'll still have to do that. So there is merit to the argument who have not done that properly in the last 2 months, Anshul, are now using the vaccine shortage excuse to cover up on the mess that we are staring at.
Yes, of course, do testing and tracking, but you cannot use the same rhetorical sermonizing language that you used about 1 year back, even now. I mean, there has to be a qualitative change in the way you address the problem. The problem now, we've entered the stage of vaccination. I mean, India, we keep comparing ourselves with the rest of the world. Barely 5% of our population has got vaccinated. I mean, you take a look at the UK, the USA, sure, their population is much less, but their vaccination drives have been far more efficient. Somebody has to give an explanation why this vaccination drive is staring down an abyss and why we are looking. Just mind you, this vaccination drive is not a complete drive. Only half of those 9 crores actually have got only half a vaccine. And like they say, a half truth is only a lie. That's why only half the people have got vaccinated. When it's time for the other half to get vaccinated or the second dose, you may not have any vaccines left. So that is the other problem that we have. So it's only half the population at the moment of 9 crores that got half a vaccine. I mean, there are innumerable problems that we have regarding the vaccination process. Sure, I mean, it should be concomitant, the testing and driving sort of program. I completely agree with you.
Okay, I'm a little short on time, but very quickly, Dr. Rawl, you wanted to make a point?
I wanted to say that just now our country head, our beloved Prime Minister said to celebrate the festival. So I want to ask without any listening to the cry of the states, how can he say that to celebrate the festival?
Yeah, actually, that's a fair point that you have raised. And I wanted even Kalikesh to respond on that. Because when you don't have the vaccines, what's this campaign that you're going to launch between 11th and 14th of April? Is there a sense that the states went too fast with the vaccination, and which is why we're staring at the shortage now?
Look, if you're going too fast with the vaccination, and if that's the reason you're having a festival, then we kind of got our priorities wrong. I mean, you can play Diwali without patakas, you can play Holi without colors, but you can't do vaccination without vaccines. That's how the life is. And you've got to step up on the game. And, you know, really, we've got to get out of this completely control-freak, bureaucratic mess that we've got ourselves into. And I honestly, I'm not blaming the BJP or the Prime Minister here. I think really we need to make access more free. We need to ensure that people get access, who want to get access, who need to get access. It cannot be rationed out. It cannot be given out as favors to states who are good with you and not to states who are not good with you. It should not be held. We should not be holding states to ransom. We should not be holding the people of the country to ransom. It's time that we allow vaccines from other manufacturers. We improve our own vaccination delivery systems and we ensure vaccines are there. And yes, we must test and we must trace. But that doesn't take away from the fact that we need to ensure that vaccination should be much more efficient.
Well, I hope now this becomes the focus of the attention for the entire country. Now that we are largely done, even with the elections, everybody can get down, sit across the table and really discuss what is the way forward to ensure an equitable distribution of vaccine, but also keeping in mind the need. I mean, you can't be giving the same amount to Gujarat and Maharashtra when the situation in Maharashtra is 10 times worse unless Gujarat is hiding something in its numbers and the population difference is almost double. That being said, the truth is that in Maharashtra, in Odisha, even in Noida and Ghaziabad, In Chhattisgarh, some of the vaccination centers don't have doses as we speak. For some, the situation is dire. For others, it's going to become worse in the next 2 to 3 days. Now, the center has promised more stocks. In fact, for Maharashtra, the center had earlier allotted 7 lakh doses in the next round. But because of all the noise that has been created in the last couple of days, the center now seems to be saying we will give you 17 lakh doses, which would probably be here in a week's time. Not enough, says Maharashtra, and that's exactly what every other state is saying. Viewers, there has to be a balance. Testing and tracking needs to be a priority. But if as a nation we've decided to ramp up our vaccination, to give it to everybody above the age of 45, to vaccinate 50 lakh people every single day, then we need to know if we have those doses. And if we do, we need to ensure that they are at the vaccination centers. It's plain and simple. Thank you so much for joining us.